What twists and turns will January have in store for us? The NFL playoffs are officially underway. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. Escapes the defender, and he will take it across midfield and down to the 45. And certainly, look, you're on the road in the playoffs. That is a suboptimal start, opening drive INT.
And, partner, sometimes I wonder, do these teams talk about it to such an extent that maybe you almost talk yourself into the turnover when you're trying to avoid it?
Yeah, maybe they get a little too worried about keeping the football, and then you give it to the other team right off the bat. And look, we said it, on the road, this is just a terrible, terrible start for them.
It is, and now they've got to rely on their defense.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league, those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Good running right there, and this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances, and he picks up nice yardage on that one.
Second and 4. Throw right side, caught by Ridley. And the Falcons are going to have a 1st and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield.
A loss of 2 brings up 2nd and goal.
Here's a 2nd and 7. This to Pitts, and he's got him. Touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Extra point splits the uprights. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
That's a little bit of humor. Gotta laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha. That was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
3 yards remain for 2nd down. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. He's got a man. It's his fullback.
Good sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Now Wilson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on 1st down.
Nice rhythm throw there on 1st down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. They go play action now. Wilson toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
On 3rd and 1, Wilson. Pass complete to DK Metcalf. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 34. Play action, it's Wilson. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he finds Lockett in the end zone. Touchdown, Seattle. Tyler Lockett, 34 yards. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. Extra point try, good by Gadeau. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Now a handoff looking right.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down. Play fake. He'll look to throw. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
So I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. He'll drop to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll lead here to a 3rd down.
Brings up 3rd and 3.
Back to throw here. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And he's going to have a Falcons first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6. These two teams all tied after 1.
7-7.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Now they try the right side here. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. A play-action fake. They'll look to throw. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal.
Brings up 2nd and goal.
And they'll run again. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. To throw here. And it's caught. They're able to hold him to 3 there, and that leads to a 4th and goal.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast too, converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up 4th down.
Can this defense hold him out? Here we go now. 4th and goal from the 2. They'll try and run for it. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Falcons have taken the lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. On 1st down, Wilson. Left side here, taken in by Metcalf. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. They go play action with Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. Space to run past the 20. And smartly going into the slide there. Wilson has enough for the first. And down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. A little juke. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to 2nd down. Throw it with Wilson. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked up by A.J. Terrell. And the Falcons are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And that is incomplete.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something is funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson is going to find his running back. It's complete, and he'll be corralled right around the 34. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now it's Wilson. Quick throw, and that's Eskridge on the slam. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Short throw to Disley. 7 yards, the pickup there. And that's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. We all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
Wilson will throw again. He'll find Metcalf. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Snags it for the pick. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard battle. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're in the position they expected to be in. They've got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
And I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run in a little more with that big offensive line. I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working. But they run it more effectively, they may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass on second down. That muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. Now back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football. Now Zach right back in the other direction. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And out will come the offense as they take over. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And three interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I was in a quarterback, the number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Throwing on second and eight. Wilson is complete to Lockett. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
On first down, dumps this one off to Chris Carson, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. From the gun, it's Wilson. It's caught, Lockett. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit, because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window, he fired a bullet in there for the completion. Carson will take the handoff out of the option play. And some room to work. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. And that one heck of a run right there. Once he got loose, you could tell that he was going to run a long way. That was pretty impressive. Gano the extra point, and that will tie our game here in the third. So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Third quarter, wild card round. Thanks for being along for the playoff ride with us. Here's second and 10. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
And that, Charles, you'd have to think, a pretty avoidable mistake.
You're exactly right about that, partner, because it all comes down to covering up the football. Look, turnovers are going to happen. They're inevitable. But in a tie game in the third quarter, those turnovers can change the tide of the ball game. And now it's up to their defense to try and bail them out. Got to take care of the rock.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. From the shotgun, Wilson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to burn down.
Third down, Wilson. He wants it all for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by A.J. Terrell. And the Falcons are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. They'll drop to throw. This one caught by Ridley. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
They'll look to throw again. He's going to put one out here to his running back. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. That'll give him 8 that time, and it'll be second down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Flushed out right. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Back to throw again. Got this complete to the tight end Pitts. And running with power here. Touchdown! Kyle Pitts. The second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Falcons
Browns have taken the lead here in the final seconds of the third quarter.
Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now 21-14. That is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone.
And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter.
One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They trail by a touchdown here in the fourth quarter. Their season, to be frank, it's on the line right now, this wild card matchup. And obviously, points are a must here as they begin first and 10. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It's only a three-yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Flush to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Now Wilson. Wide open receiver complete. Touchdown, Seahawks. Will Dislin, 61 yards.
And the Seahawks are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Out there for their next drive. And it's all on the line now, all even in this wild card matchup. Maybe their most important drive of the season coming up right now here, first and 10. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Looking to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
19, Tiger.
They'll set up a throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. He's got his pass-catching tight end. That's Pitts. Oh, he's got a little daylight. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Great effort there. He scored with that into the air. And the Falcons answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. extra point splits the uprights, and they will take a 7-point lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial drive, first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Will Disley, the intended receiver, and a bring up second down. You and I watched film yesterday, and he told me to watch his feet. For whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Yeah, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Wilson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. To throw is Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
It's now second and 6.
And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Dwayne Eskridge there to make the grab. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up. We are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for 2, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. So right back to square one. Tied at 28 as he kicks it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. He'll look to throw. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They're going to look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And down inside the 15 he goes. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. They'll look to throw. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. All tied up, less than 2 minutes to go. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop. 1:50 left in the football game. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Here's Wilson. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So they'll try to move the ball closer here on third down. A field goal from this spot would be just inside of 60 yards, 59 to be exact. Throwing now is Wilson. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. There's an option to the short side, and that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So their task a little bit more difficult now, second and 13 that they're walking up on. Wilson to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. So they'll get 8 out of that completion. And they're going to face a third down. Here's Carson. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. So out of the field now, Graham Gano in a big spot. This to take the lead here in the final minute. Gano's kick is good, and the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one, whether you're able to get into field goal range or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Back to throw. Right back to Pitts again. And he's brought down. Well, one win down, still three to go to get to the most hallowed ground in sports, but a good start.
A terrific start because they get to move on. Unfortunately for the team that lost, it's a long offseason ahead for them now.